What is the area of this square? All right, what's going on, you guys? Welcome to another interesting, challenging mathematics problem on prime logic. Today I've got an interesting problem for you from the SAT geometry exam. It looks easy, but it's, I think, tricky enough. It's a solid problem. So if you want to solve this problem, please pause the video because I'm going to solve this video right now. So we have a square, and all we have here is the length of this hypotenuse is 4 units, and the length of this hypotenuse is 1 unit long. So you are asked to calculate the area of the square. So let's start. So let's name some things so for better calculating. So let's name the side of this square as, let's say, A. So this is A. Let's name this angle as alpha. Let's name this angle as beta. So beta is 90 degrees minus alpha, right? Because this is a right angle triangle. And this line is 180 degrees. Like this whole angle is 180 degrees. And we have a 90 degree here. So this is 90 degrees minus alpha, which is beta, right? So let me write it down here. And then we have a right angle here because that's the side of the square. So we have 90 degrees, beta, and this must be alpha. So now we have two triangles whose angles, interior inside angles, are literally the same. It means that all these triangles are similar based on this rule, which is angle, 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 triple angle rule. So the angles are the same. So we can write down now this some relationships, some proportions based on this to kind of find the side of this square. So let's name also this side as x. And this is the whole length of the square is a. So this must be a minus x. So now let's write down some proportions. So from this triangle and this triangle. So for example, this corresponding side of angle alpha, so which is x. So we can write it down as x over the corresponding side of angle alpha, and this bigger triangle is a. So x over a equals, so we have the hypotenuse here. So let's write it down. It's 1 over 4. It means A equals 4x. So that's maybe our first relationship that we found. And based on this second big triangle, let's write down the Pythagorean theorem now. So we know that based on the Pythagorean theorem, A squared, this side squared, plus this side squared, which is a minus x squared, equals hypotenuse squared, which is 16. So we know that a is 4x, right? So let's just replace it now. So 4x squared is 16x squared plus, so a is 4x. So 4x minus x is 3x. The whole thing squared is 9x squared equals 16. So based on this, let's simplify that. So 25x squared equals 16. In other words, so x equals the square root of 16 over 25. Of course, that's in calculus, it is a plus minus, right? But now we are in geometry phase, so the minus or negative dimension or size, it's meaningless. So we just consider the positive value. So x equals 4 over 5. Now, a equals 4 times x, which is 16 over 5. So now that's easy. We found out A. We calculated the length of A. So if we have this setup with hypotenuse 4 and hypotenuse 1, then the side of this square must be 16 over 5, which is a little more than 3. Now, the last step is obviously the area of this square equals, so a square, right? So it is a square, which is 16 over 5, the whole thing square, which is 256 over 25. So that's the answer, and that's the solution for this video and this problem. I have a task for you. I want you, any of you who's following and watching this video, I want you to do an upgrade on this problem, on this setup, kind of like a bonus challenge, and update this challenge to make it much, much more difficult. So imagine this was kind of the level one. So how can you add maybe some shapes? Maybe you can inscribe a circle or add more geometry shapes, or I don't know. So use your imagination, and I want you to escalate the level of difficulty of this problem. So I think that's gonna wrap it up for today. I want you to drop your thoughts and answers in the comments below with whatever method you chose to solve this video. Obviously, that's not the only method. I'm really looking forward to seeing your methods and intuitive approaches. So if you haven't liked or subscribed our channel, please like and subscribe. And this gives me a lot of energy. And see you in our next video on prime logic.